Hello student, today we learn about the next new function in Excel. So the first one is here, web page. Here I am writing the web page, E-B-E-R-A-G-E. And then here we can find out the average of that given number. How we can find out the average? We can start writing the equal sign in this formula bar and then we can write average. AP. Now see this average is there, so we can click on this average. Okay, press the space bar key, or we can write here the continuously. We can write here the average. Okay, this one, and then what we have to do, we can start the bracket here. Okay, and then click on the first range. So I'm clicking on this one, and then use the colon sign, and the next range is there. Automatically we can select here the SST marks and then close the bracket. Now see the average of that particular range from B2 to F2 is there, average is there 53. According to that, if you find out the next average of that given value, then what we have to do, that same thing we can apply here also, drag this small narrow plus sign and find out there the average. Okay. The next function, if we find out the next function there, the next function I am telling you that power. If you find out the power, power it means if you are writing here some value, like if I am writing here the power of, I am writing starting with here equal and then start writing the number. For a particular given number having some power, right, I am writing there 23, then comma, reach to the power. Here the power is here 3. Then what we have to do here, starting we can write there the power P-O-W-E-R. Okay, and then close the bracket after this 3. Here I am writing this 23. It means 23 raised to the power 3. It means 23 raised to the power 3. Here you can write any number, like if I am writing the 4, it means 23 raised to the power 4, but I am writing here the 3 and then press the enter sign after this bracket and then you can find out the power of this particular number. It is 1167. It means if we divide it there 23 into 23, it means it is 1167. Okay, it is in power. The next one is there. After average, then power, then I find out that the square root. Square root, as you know, that the square root. Like if I am writing there the 49. 49 square root is there 7. So like this, if I am writing there 36, then the square root is there 6. 6 is the 36. So like how we can find out the square root? Here I am writing starting with the equal sign. Then we can write SQ. RT, this is the function name of there for square root. Okay, then start bracket. To the number you can write, which we can find out there the square root. So here I am writing like the 49. Okay, and then close the bracket, press the enter sign. Then you can see there the power, the square root of 49 is there 7. Okay, again you can see there. How we can find out the square root? Like if I am writing the SQRT, this is the name of the square root, function is the square root, start the bracket and then we can write there, like if I am writing here 36 and close the bracket and then I am pressing the enter sign. So now see here 6, the 36, it is also a square root. But no need to drag that particular bit, because now if we are dragging then automatically in all the cells having 1, 2, 1, 6, 7, because the calculation is there only for particular cell only. Okay, because the number which we have to put it here only, it changes the value for according to that only, it means 1, 2, 1, 6 for their 23 only. And it is also 6 means the square root of 36 is their 6. Okay, the next one is their mode. Mode it means to find out the remainder value. If we divide the number, then the here I am writing the mode, okay. And this one is there the square root. Here I am writing the square root, okay. Mode. How we can find out the mode? Like if I am writing there equal mode, okay. okay, then start the bracket, and then I am writing here one value. Now see their number, then comma, then divider. Number you can write, if I am writing here 13, 13 divided by the divisor, I am writing here 2. So the remainder is there automatically 1. So mode we are using to find out here the remainder. So the remainder is there 1. Okay, so according to that, now you can use their all the function like average, power, square root, and mode. And then last day you learn about the sum, max, and min. That's all for today. That's all complete function you can use it today. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.